All right, y'all. We back with one more chance. Episode 8 and 9. We've been missing for a while, but we back. Your girl Sweepy got the recap. Pull up a seat. We gonna be here for a while. For a little bit, but your girl figured out a way around it. So sit back and enjoy the show. We're gonna give people a minute to get in here, but we're gonna have a great show tonight. One more chance, episode 8 and 9 review, and then we got the finale followed right after. Your girl Sweet Pea with the one more chance review coming in the room, y'all. Let's go. Get in here. Come on, y'all. Let's go. Where y'all at? It's your girl Sweet Pea, and I'm back with another video. Now this video is for my subbies, for my OGs out there that have been with me from the beginning to now, that have watched all of the One More Chance reviews, all the watch parties. This is for y'all. Tiffany HBIC Pollard has entered the Stallionaire's Ranch. So Tiffany enters into the ranch tongue and Chance down, okay? I know you guys have all seen the clip where Tiffany and Chance are kissing, but really that's all it was. It was just a fleeting moment. They kissed. It was based off of memories, you know, from them being on a show in the past and the fact that he called Tiffany to the ranch to help him judge these girls. It just made for an interesting moment, but that's all it was. It was a moment. They kissed and they moved on. Now we are down to 6. We have Cheeks, Yummy, Roly Poly Snacks, Unbelievable, Believable, Shira, and Yolala. And yes, Mangina did get eliminated. All right, so the first woman that Tiffany sits down with is Shira. She's the white girl with the passion twist. And, you know, when she sits down in the hot seat, you know, all of the girls, as a matter of fact, when they come in the room, like I said, they don't know that they're meeting with New York. So Shira was one of the main ones, was like, oh, shit, it's New York. And so New York is like, yeah, bitch, it's me. And what kind of fucking braids are those? That is her first question. You're giving me very much Iggy Azalea. And what kind of fucking braids are those? And so the white girl has to tell the black woman that these are passion twists. I really was a little disappointed at that, because I'm like, come on, Tiffany. You know what kind of fucking braids those are. There's plenty black women that wear those braids. You act like she actually told her that they look like a mop on her head. And they don't. The braids actually look pretty. And I think that Shira is pretty. So let's just stop with with referencing the black, you know, hairstyle on the white girl. That's tired and that's old. There was another comment that Tiffany made to Shira. Have you ever been with a black man with a big cock? Okay, with a big D word is really what she said. And I was just like, oh, okay. And Shira, yes, I have actually. Yes, all the time. Girl, you don't have to make that connotation that you take black dick on a regular basis if you don't. Next woman up is Unbelievable. Believable, Unbelievable. At this point, I'm not even sure what they're calling her anymore. This is the woman with the chin that is always being poked at for being having a low tone, a low voice. She speaks like this. Her chin's like this. So that means she must be a man. All right. So that is all more of what Tiffany was giving. She was questioning Unbelievable, Believable on her genitalia. She was basically saying, trying to get her to talk loud, be loud, and she was sharing the sentiment that Chance and everyone does not believe that she's really a woman. And so Believable's like, well, I don't know why. Chance has seen my baby pictures. I've shown him, you know, my private parts. We spent alone time together. And the fact that this woman has had to constantly, you know, explain that she's a woman, that's terrible. So we're going to actually cover that a little bit more in detail at the end, because that is a problem that I actually have with Zeus about this topic. They just won't let it go. Like, they covered the shit with Mangina being a transgender, but really wasn't a transgender. And now they are covering it again with Believable, that, oh, you have this soft-spoken voice, so somehow you cannot be a real woman, because what, you're supposed to be screaming and hollering and yelling, and you're supposed to be ratchet and all of this. So her and Believable, you know, they have their back and forth, and it was just really given all of that. Believable trying to make people believe that she was a woman. And Tiffany's like, I don't believe you. I don't think you're really here for Chance. You're fake. You're phony, you know. And so she was just given that. Next runner up was Yolala. Now, we all know who Yolala is. Yolala is that high yellow one with that yellow ass lace front that keeps pulling up at the sides. You know, she's all rah-rah, bada-ballot, and everybody says that she has a pimp, okay? That this girl is being pimped on the outside. She's just there for clout. She's just trying to be seen. And, you know, she sits down in front of Tiffany, and you already know what happened. It was a bunch of scripping and scrapping, a bunch of hollering and yelling, because Tiffany came at her with all that bravado and all of what Tiffany HBIC gives. You know, Tiffany is the queen of reality. She started this. You know, she put y'all bitches on. And so she was basically letting Yolala know, like, bitch, ask your mommy about me. Bitch, do you know who you are talking to? Tone it down. And so Yolala, you know, she's not going to back down. She's just like your typical young girl these days. And she's like, bitch, I don't give a fuck who you are. I don't care who's mammy. You're old and I'm young. You're old. She just kept making, you're old. She just kept making reference to that. You're old. And I don't give a damn. Go sit your old ass down. Get your hands out my face. So it was a bunch of that. And then they actually almost got into a fight. They're off camera. And it's all that going back and forth. And Tiffany is loving it. She's poking at her. You know, she's very much, you can tell in her face, she's giving, bitch, I'm the queen. And I'm fucking with you. And, you know, I like you though, you know, and she's trying to calm Yolala down and bring her back in the house. Cause at this point, Yolala done got out, came out her shoes, honey. She outside screaming and hollering, and you know, and I'm thinking, what the fuck are these neighbors thinking? Like, the house that they're in is on a damn residential block. It's not even a mansion that's up in the damn hills anywhere. But you know, that's how California is. Southern California is very congested. And so some of these neighborhoods that have, you know, houses that are million-dollar houses. They're in regular residential neighborhoods because California is very expensive to live in. So chance this house that he's claiming is his is in a residential neighborhood. These houses are right next to each other. So I know the neighborhood is like, here go these ratchet ass reality TV people out here yet again screaming and hollering because Yola was very much giving that shit. Like, girl, get your hands out my face. I'm who I am. And, you know, I'm here to win. I love Chance, but if not, bitch, I'm ready to go home. So she's basically like, I'm ready to go. And Tiffany basically talked her into staying. And then, you know, we got the next one up. Roly Poly Snacks Mills. That's our favorite girl. The big, large BBW honey that eats and has snacks and just allowed these people to constantly make fun of her being fat and eating. She comes down and sits in front of New York, and she's actually happy to see New York. And her and New York actually got along. Out of all of the girls, I feel that their chemistry was the best. Because she is actually down for Chance. Like, Roly Poly, out of all of them, is always calling Chance her man, you know, and talking about how she got his back, and that's her man, and she love her man. And so those were the type of questions that Tiffany was asking each of the girls. What are you really here for? Are you really here for Chance? Do you love Chance? You know, and after only 2 weeks of being with Chance, honey, some of these girls say they love this man, okay? So we're going to see if this show is going to live up to the name One More Chance, that these people are actually going to be in love after the show, that they're actually going to be together. I want to see if that shit is really what's going to happen. Because the way these girls are acting, honey, they love this man. And any other reality show that is like a dating show, it doesn't seem like the people stay together. So let's see if One More Chance, if whoever wins, if they stay with Chance. So during the conversation between Roly Poly and New York, honey, New York says, well, I hear about, what's this throat action I hear about? And I hear, you know, Chance's concern is that you're going to eat him out of house and home. And Roly Poly's like, no, girl. You know, she pulls a goddamn banana out of her titties, peels that damn banana back, and put it in her mouth and pulled it out as though it was a penis. It went all the way down her throat and it came back out, honey. It was unharmed. It wasn't even bitten into. Not a nick was touched. Okay, it went down and back out. She is a pro. All right, and so she bit off a piece of it while she was talking. Then she pulled out some goddamn Cheetos, and New York had it was a lot. And New York was like, okay, all right, now girl, this is what Chance is talking about. He's concerned that you're going to eat him out of house and home. And then Roly Poly had the nerve to say, girl, I get food stamps. I get food stamps, so my covers and my refrigerator stay full. So we will be just fine. I will be watching the refrigerator. I'll make sure we got food. And he ain't got to worry about me touching his money. We're going to have food. I fell out. But, you know, again, this is entertainment. This shit cannot be real. It can't be. All right, and next up we have Cheeks. Now, Cheeks, we know she is very much tomboyish. She came into the room with her biker shorts on, honey, and her little t-shirt and sneaks. And when New York saw her, she fell out. It's like, oh, shit. You know, we got a little tomboy in the house. So between the back and forth and just the whole way Cheeks was carrying herself, and we know how she talked, she's very much tomboyish and thuggish, you know, even though she's a dancer. You know, New York was like, oh, so I know your name is Cheeks because of your behind. Let me see a little bit of it. So Cheeks gets down, you know, and she does the little pop, 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 1-2-1-2, left cheek, right cheek, twerk. And New York is like, okay, I see you live up to the hype. You live up to your name. However, what's your sign? So she's like, I'm a Capricorn. And New York says, I'm a Capricorn too. I'm January 6th. And so Cheek says, I'm January 7th. So boom, they got a little, you know, connection right there. But New York also says, so then you like to eat a little kitty cat every now and then. And Cheek says, yes, I do. So they had a little candor laughing, kikiing over that, because New York now says, all right, so you're bi. And so she's like, yes, I'm bi. So, you know, New York is like, basically, teasing her and saying like, girl, you know, Chance and I, you know, we had something and we could possibly do a threesome and we can, so honey, it went all into that conversation where they can have a threesome and Cheeks was really trying to play into that. You know, she's sitting back doing the whole thuggish thing and trying to flirt with New York. But I could tell that New York was just using that, as a candid moment. Okay, everybody's fucking bi these days. So what? Some women like to eat kitty cat. All right, so she wanted to do. But don't think that that's going to make you win, honey, because New York got something for your ass. Because right in the middle of all that skinning and grinning, New York said, okay, get up, bye, go. So all of that, you thinking that you was planning to the whole eating kitty cat and you're bi and making her blush, honey, she told you to get your ass on up out of there right in the middle of your sentence. So she sent her on away, you know, and that was the end of their conversation. So now we're on to the last contestant, and that is our girl Yummy. So we already know, you know, Yummy thinks she got this thing sewed up because, you know, Yummy has actually, you know, been with Chance. You know, it could be said that she's given him oral or they actually had sex. You know, she alludes that they actually slept together and he alludes that it was just head. But either way, it was sex. So, you know, she comes on the scene and New York is like, so this is the girl that thinks, you know, she has it all sewed up. You know, what do you feel like you have competition? She's like, no, you know, me and Chance have something going. You know, we're feeling each other. And, you know, basically New York is saying to her like, yeah, I see you. You are cute. You are the typical. But what are you here for? Are you here for clout? Do you date? It's rumored that you're dating an NBA player. So I guess this girl used to date an NBA player. And she's like, no, I don't date him anymore. You know, it's well known that it is over. I'm here for Chance. I'm on my way to loving Chance. And so New York's whole question to all these girls are, do you love Chance? And so her answer, Yummy's answer, was, you know, no, I don't really love him, but I'm on my way to loving him. My whole thing is this. How the fuck do you expect somebody to love someone after 2 weeks? I know that this is a show, but come on, stop throwing that word around like it's just, oh yeah, you know, I love him. But Yummy was honest and she was like, I'm growing to love him and like him deeper like that. We do have a connection, but I'm not going to say that I love him at this point. So basically, now that all the girls have talked to New York and Chance are sitting down in the foyer, and New York is like, if you want me to eliminate these girls, honey, I've been and sent them all home. Because none of them that are here are worth any goddamn time, okay? They all are piece are trash. Where did you find these girls? Basically, where the fuck did you find these Z-list wannabe-ass, you know, girls that just want to be on TV? And so she's like, I've been and sent them all home and sat down on your dick at the end of the night. When she said that, did she just really say that? So Chance is asking, you know, New York to do the elimination. And none of the girls know that she's going to be the one doing elimination. So now it comes time for the elimination and she's sitting in the chair. So as each one of them come, she's got two hats on a little table next to her. And she's telling each of them, you know, as they come through, I'm here to judge you. I'm here to do the elimination. So basically, she sent home everyone except for Yolita and Yummy. So now where we are, you know, we are at the point where she sent home Shira because she didn't feel like Shira, you know, was really down for Chance. She sent home Roly Poly Snacks because she's big and all she's going to do is eat. She sent home Cheeks because, you know, she felt that Cheeks is really, you know, a lesbian, that she would be more so a fun girl, that she wouldn't really be down for Chance, that she would be, you know, just there to please Chance. These are her excuses. Really, this show was set up from the beginning. I knew the type that Chance was looking for, and I knew that he was going to keep Yolita and Yummy. It was just set up. It was obvious. And, I mean, if you went into a competition throwing your kitty cat around, slobbing and knobbing and doing all that, girl, you're going to stay there, too. You know, so she basically bought her seat at the table. Now, Yolita is just a casualty. I do not believe that she's going to win. She's just the other light-skinned girl. It's two light-skinned girls left, basically. The whole look, that whole, you know, fun girl look, you know, pretty girl look, that's what he's left with to choose from. So it's going to go into that, into the last episode where they're going to be at a dinner table and it's the three of them, and that's when he's going to choose who he's picking. So this show is giving me very much, it's all scripted, it's all set up, but you know, we used to just watch it because it was fun to watch. However, I have a bone to pick. Now, the character Believable, she's better than me, okay? Because this woman has been taunted throughout this whole goddamn series, okay? She's been asked repeatedly, is she a woman? And when she was eliminated by New York, New York straight up told her, I'm eliminating you because I feel like you have dick and balls. You have sweaty dick and balls and that you are a man. She said it just like that. I was so disappointed in New York. New York had me as a fan up until that point. When New York came out and said that, I was just done. You know, I watch New York and I see on her social media that she is a heavily into the drag scene. She is friends with T.S. Madison. And for you to sit here and poke at this woman and constantly tell her that she's a man and she got sweaty dick and balls between her legs, T.S. Madison need to call you up and put you in your goddamn place if she has not done it already. She need to unfollow your ass, and anytime she has called you a sister or said anything kind to you, she needs to backtrack and take that shit all back. Because you are not in favor of the trans girls, drag girls, queer girls, any type of girls. If you sat there and told this woman that is actually born a woman that she has a sweaty dick and balls between her legs, then you asked her, how do you feel about me saying that to you? And she just sat there not knowing what to say or what to do. Now, if it comes out later that this woman is actually a man or she was born a man, she's still a woman because she transitioned to a woman. So you still are disrespecting her in that sense because you told her that she's got a sweaty dick and balls between her legs. New York, you are trash. And at this point, I am not a fan of yours anymore. You know, I don't like shit like that. And I feel like when you cross the line and you shame a woman and she's got to fucking prove to you who she is, you cross the line. Although they may have brought Tiffany to the table, Zeus, you made an error in judgment by continuing with this storyline. The fact that you continued to put Mangina on a pedestal and, you know, as being a trans, but you allowed her to be poked fun at and be called a dude and a he, she, and Mangina, just the name alone. And then you have a woman that is actually a woman, and you are telling her that she looks more like a man and has a dick and balls between her legs than the man that really did have a dick. It was just too much, and it was just poor taste, and that just shows to the character of the people over there at Zeus. And you have a nerve to be striking my channel for me playing this content. You should be glad that anyone is playing the content, because at this point it is just trash. All right, so the show ends with a teaser of the next episode, which is going to air next Sunday, and it's going to be with Yolala and Yummy having dinner with Chance, and after the dinner, he's going to decide who the winner is. My prediction is Yummy. Of course, she's that typical light-skinned, you know, biracial girl that black men are into these days. She's already given her Yummy up, so she's probably going to be the winner. So stay tuned. I will be reviewing that, and I'll let you guys know what happens. And it looks like they are also going to have a reunion show. So I will tune in, watch it, and come back and let you guys know what happened. All right, so thank you for tuning in to the Sweet Pea Diaries. It has been a blast. If you're a new subscriber, thank you for finding us. Be sure to subscribe and like this video. For all my OGs, y'all, I tried to give it to you the best way I could. Sorry that I'm not able to upload it, but Zeus some 8 nasty bitches. All right, y'all, bye. Thank you for tuning in.